And so in this final demonstration, let's finish off our report development work beyond report development by taking a look at URL parameters and subscriptions. So this is where we left off earlier, having rendered our report that we'd published up to the service. And so when I come to the file menu here, I can open up Generate Link, and here is a link to the report, including the parameter selection that's been made.
Yes, it would be at the end of the URL.
All right, let's copy this, and I'm just going to paste it into Notepad so it's a little easier to see. All right, there's a bit of encoding going on here, but the parameter, see here, report parameter named date fiscal year is here to here. Mm-hmm. Because it's MDX, it's actually a hierarchical path to get to it. But let's take a look at this, FY2019. So what I'm going to do is modify that to the previous year, 2018, and I'm going to append to the query string with the ampersand RDL colon format equals PDF. So now here's a request in a single URL to download the PDF of the 2018 sales performance. So in a new web session, I just paste that URL in. And there it is. What does it mean for our expand and collapse drill down? So here's an example where toggling visibility isn't a good choice if you intend to render it as PDF. Or if you do, and I've done this enough before, because we want the same report to work for different formats. So I would add a report parameter that says expand all, yes or no.
Yep.
And if you then set that to no, then that would be the default in HTML. Well, then we'd expand as we need it. Mm-hmm. But if my intention is to print it or output to PDF, I'd set that parameter to yes. An expression would be assigned to the toggling of visibility, and then we would see all data. Right, the second part of this demonstration then is to explore subscriptions. I would like to have this sent to myself or to others on a scheduled basis. So up on the menu, I simply open up subscribe, and it's here where I'm going to go ahead and click to add a subscription.
You already are adding a subscription.
And now that I've added a subscription, thanks, Chris, then we can choose format. Here's where we want to be careful with parameters. If we intend to use defaults, what are we going to do, Chris?
If you want to use the default parameters, then you want to use the default parameter option. If you've entered values, or if you choose use current and haven't typed anything, you'll end up using the defaults as well.
Okay. This is where you can enter email addresses, the subject and the message for the email, the frequency from hourly to monthly, the start date to the end date.
Yes.
Do we include a link?
Normally, you want to include a link so people can go back to the report if they so choose. However, there are customers who would prefer just to send an attachment, so you can hide that optionally.
What about if we send the subscription to someone that's never internal, and so they could never open it anyway?
Well, actually, that's a feature that is being rolled out here in the coming weeks. From depending on when you're watching this, it may be already available. And the idea there is if you include a link and include access to the report, they'll actually have a workflow to come back and be added as a user in the Active Directory there for the tenant.
Right.
So it'll go through the B2B workflow, and they would then be able to view it in the service.
So
as
it's
well.
Still relevant to
yes,
add a link.
Exactly.
Because they can be granted guest privileges.
Yep.
And then the preview image, what does that look like? I've not seen it.
So when you actually, so this is actually a little bit different than what we do with SSRS. With Power BI reports today, when you go in and set up a subscription, it gives you an image of the page that you've chosen. One of the things we added here is, wouldn't it be nice to still give people that nice preview of the first page of their report directly in the mail itself? So we give you that preview image there. You can choose to have it or not, but you'll still get the report attached.
Is it like a thumbnail or it's a large?
No, it's a full-size picture.
Great. So we will save and close, and then Power BI will look after that for you. You do have the ability to run immediately if you want to test it, or this is where you could choose to disable, or when you're done, I've had enough, delete the subscription.
Yep.
Awesome. I think that brings us to the end of our story, Chris, and Paginated Report there.
Thanks.
All right, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for some bonus content that rounds out the rest for this course. Thank you.